welcome everyone to the most eagerly anticipated event of the year, our annual Staff Awards Ceremony 2024. Ladies and gentlemen, I will not be your host for the evening. However, I would like to welcome our marketing manager, Ms. Sansha Raghi, and our marketing officer, Danny Augustine. Let's give them a round of applause.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you, Tamika. And I guess I started off as a co-host last year, and then I got the prestige of being the host, and I kind of roped in Danny to be my co-host. So welcome, everybody. I would like to acknowledge the presence of our managing director, Mr. Martin Dorville. Give it a wave. Our leadership team, our store and warehouse managers, our guest speaker, Dr. Cletus Burton. He's running a little bit late, but we will get him later on this evening. Out to our team members, families, and friends in YouTube land, hi. So our prestigious nominees. Tonight, we gather to celebrate you. You are our shining stars from Massey Stores and Massey Distribution. As we embark on this journey of recognition and appreciation, get ready to raise the roof filled with applause as we honor you, those who make our workplace not just a family, but a Massey family. So without further ado, let the celebration begin. So let me call on a representative from Sandals to do our health and safety protocols.
A pleasant good evening, everyone. Welcome to Sandals Grand St. Lucian Spa and Retreat Resort. I do hope you have a wonderful evening with us. You're welcome. So in case of an emergency, hopefully we don't have to do that, but we do have exit doors towards the back. We have three towards my left, but the middle exit door is obstructed. So please do not exit through that door. So everyone, remember where you came in, where the entrance was, the gate towards the back. This is where everyone will head towards. Don't go left, don't go around the property, just go straight through the gates that you came in.
Don't go to your left.
Right. We do have washrooms available for you, so you would exit through any of the exit doors and you exit through the main entrance door of the ballroom. We have two glass doors, you exit through that door and it's down the hall on the left. All right, so we do have team members around. Any questions you have, we're here to assist you throughout the evening. Do enjoy.
And as always with Massey Stores, we always begin our proceedings with gratitude and prayer. So let us welcome God into our midst. Leah Emmanuel, can you come up to do the prayer?
Happy good evening to everyone. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice tonight and be glad in it. So let us rejoice. I'd like to quote the Bible, Matthew chapter 25, verse 20 to 21, before we start praying. And so he that had received 5 talents came and brought other 5 talents, saying, Lord, thou deliverest unto me 5 talents. Behold, I have gained besides them 5 talents more. His Lord said unto him, well, His Lord said unto him, Well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things, and I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord. So I need to say to you winners tonight, we celebrate you. So can we stand in prayer, please, everyone? Father, we thank you this evening. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for all of our winners tonight. Father, we celebrate you, and it's because we celebrate you that we are able to celebrate our team members. We thank you for the organizers. We thank you for Massey Stores St. Lucia Limited and Massey Distribution. We thank you for our managing director, Martin Dorville. We thank you for wisdom. We thank you that he will continue to guide us in running the operations of the business. We thank you for our leadership members, our store managers, every single team member, especially those who are viewing us, also to those who are actually operating the stores as we celebrate this evening. We thank you, Lord, for them. We thank you for our customers who are also joining us. We thank you for every one of us here this evening. Father, we pray that you will continue to bestow your blessings upon us. We pray, Lord God, that we shall remain green as the trees planted by the rivers of water. We thank you for vision. We thank you for our mission of love and care. We thank you for allowing us to be on the tables of all St. Lucians. We thank you, Lord, that you will continue to allow us to provide for every single St. Lucian. As we continue this ceremony this evening, we pray that let your joy be our strength tonight. And we pray, Lord God, that you will give us traveling mercies to our homes at the end of this ceremony. We thank you, Lord, that you shall bless this food that you will provide for us. You shall bless this food and also the blesser, those who prepared the food. And we shall partake it in your mighty name. We all say amen.
Thank you, Leah. We now move into the welcome remarks by our Divisional Head of Human Resources, HSSE, and Training, Mrs. Nicola Velina Paul.
Thank you so much, Danny and Sancho. You all have done an awesome job so far. And Leah, thank you so much, as always, for your very fervent prayer. I know that our prayers from Mercy are always heard by the Lord. Wow. Guys, every year around this time, I am just absolutely floored. So this year, we chose our theme. Our theme this year is Elevate. That's what we said we wanted to do. And you guys have truly elevated. You look so wonderful, you look beautiful. According to what sometimes I say to my friends, you guys clean up well. You look so lovely. So good evening, everyone. Welcome to our Staff Appreciation Awards for 2024. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Sancho, Mr. Gordon Charles, right there, you didn't see him. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Gordon Charles. Gordon is no stranger to us at Massey Stores. He's on the board of directors. So Gordon, welcome. And Gordon, as soon as we sent the invitation to Gordon, he responded yes one time. I don't think he hesitated. So Gordon, thank you so much and welcome to our presentation. Our guest speaker, Dr. Cletus Burton, I heard say that he was running a little bit late. Thank you. And also, Dr. Burton is no stranger to Mercy. Dr. Burton has been doing some excellent work with us on our leadership program, and he's also doing some work with our 4 hours a program for our managers. So he is no stranger to us, and I am really looking forward to hearing what he has to share with you this evening. Welcome to our team members. All of you here, our leadership team members, those of you who are joining us online, and those of you who are taking a little sneak peek at the store, welcome. We miss you, but I think your fellow team members here are representing you very well. We are here once again, continuing the proud tradition of celebrating those among us who continue to show exemplary performances in their respective areas of responsibility. Last year at this time, you will recall we were ushering the new era of the Massey Group and its 100th anniversary. Our theme this year, Elevate, is really in keeping with this, moving forward to higher heights. What does elevate mean? A simple dictionary definition says that this word means to raise or lift something to a higher position or raise to a more impressive level. As our environment continues to change rapidly around us, it demands that we raise our performance, that we lift each other and our organizations to higher and impressive levels. At this point, it would be remiss of me to not mention one of our own who has been raised to one of the highest levels of acknowledgement in this country. And I would like to, in case you didn't know, I would like to let you know that Mr. Robert Thomas of IT was awarded the National Service Award for outstanding contributions and exemplary dedication to service, community, and country. Robert's unwavering commitment to service and accomplishments serves as an inspiration to all of us. Those of you who know Robert well knows that Robert has given yeoman service. Anytime there's a disaster within St. Lucia or the Caribbean, Robert is one of those persons who would be called upon. So I'd like all of you to join me in congratulating Robert on this achievement. This year, we sought to do the Appreciate the Staff Awards a little differently. We wanted to get some involvement from the audience. So there are some new aspects to what we will do. If you notice, there was a barcode on your individual tables which says Scan Me, and this is for the Spirit Award. At the appropriate time, the host will indicate to you when to scan and start the voting process. Hey, some of you have voted already. So how y'all know the people? Okay. We have also expanded the range of the awards that we give. We have separated the HSSE and the engagement awards. So these are awards that we are giving in addition to the traditional awards. We have also separated the warehouses from the location, so the warehouses and the home store will be receiving separate awards for each business type. So I'm really looking forward to an exciting evening. Of course, I know who all the winners are. You don't, but I know that I am pretty sure that you will join me in congratulating all of the winners this evening. So I'd like you to sit back, relax, and really savor and enjoy our Staff Appreciation Awards 2024. Thank you, everybody. And just as a note, when you're coming up, those of you who are coming up, please hold on to the railings so as extra support, okay? We have some kind of long dresses. I have to lift this up for me to come on. So.
All right, thank you, Nicola, for your very warm and elevated welcome. So, our next speaker needs absolutely no introduction. Our managing director, Martin Dovill.
Danny tells me, don't forget to hold the railings, and he ain't holding the railings. I look at every aspect of HSSC, and Nicola, thanks for that. I think don't want anybody getting hurt. I would like to more profoundly acknowledge the presence of Gordon Charles. Gordon is not just the director, but Gordon is also a shareholder, and Gordon embraces a lot of what we do, as an organization, and I know that this evening in particular, Gordon is under a lot of pressure because he has a lot of deliverables, but I'm amazed that he could still find the time to come and spend with us here, because it was definitely optional for him. He could have bowed out gracefully and say, I really am too busy. So Gordon, I really do appreciate your presence here this evening. And it does make the environment feel a lot warmer and comfortable for me, so thank you. This is the year of elevation, and I recalled it was at a store managers meeting that we had, and we were having some profound discussions, the kind of discussion that I like as the leader of the organization. And I recall, managers, you all were challenging each other. We were challenging ourselves to do better around quite a number of things. And the sentiment and the feeling cropped out that this really should be the year of elevation. Now, the amazing thing about it is that I don't want you to coin that period in terms of when we started our financial year. Your year can start now. Your year starts now. The year of elevation for you starts now. The year of thinking positively and elevating starts now. So you can pick whatever time. But from now for the next 12 months, or it could have been 6 months before, or it could start tomorrow, this will be a year of elevation. You get me? Right, so what is this thing we call elevation? If you recall, one of our values is growth and continuous improvement. Well, there is no better time to take this value and begin dissecting it for you to understand that a big part of that is about elevation. Elevation of yourself, elevation of your team, elevation of the organization. So there are three paradigms or three dimensions that I put to this, which is elevation of ourselves. I'll take leadership to begin with. When we think elevation, what are we thinking of? Well, one of the things I'd like to say, and it was Maria who said that term quite a few times, and Maria Alcius. We have to give credit for people who inspire us in a particular way, and she inspires me because of how passionate she is about food and food safety. So I don't know, I don't think she has won an award, but give Maria a round of applause for me, because she does inspire us. And she always says to us, she always says, hold on to your gains. You all have heard that from her before, right? Hold on to your gains. It means whatever progress we have made, we cannot fall back from it. We hold on to our gains, and it is from there that we elevate, right? So one of the things as a leadership that we must do is to make sure we hold on to our gains. What protects us from that are our policies, are the standards that we set for the organization and for ourselves. And one of the things I need to implore you to do is to keep holding on to that gain. Let us not fall back. The other thing that is very, very important is that this is a year of growth, but it is less a year of growth through, as we say, putting up new stores and putting up new buildings. It is a year of growth of ourselves as a people, as the prime resource for the organization. So it will not be investments in buildings and capex and so forth. Yeah, we must do that. But Celia is there and she's watching me intently. We need to begin to transform ourselves as the prime resource of the organization. So there you see where you must begin to elevate yourself. And I'm sure somewhere in Dr. Burton's messages to us, he will talk about how he takes part as in transforming and uplifting and elevating. So the leadership paradigm, we see elevation through the strength of our people. So we have agreed, and I have agreed, and I have transformed my thinking, where we spend less time focusing on the things we don't like about each other. Because I challenge you, if you want to find things about Martin Dovell you don't like, you will find plenty. If I want to find out things that I don't like, even about the best of you in that room, I will find plenty. As a leadership, what we have committed to doing is to find the strength in our people, to see the superhero qualities in our people. And that's what leadership does. Because if you go looking for the bad things, how are you going? Think of how consumed you become when you start to talk about your colleague in a negative way. It consumes you. You can spend the whole day talking about it. Yet, all of us were employed for our strength. All of us were employed for the things that are great about us. And I don't want us to cease looking at that. Yes, as a leadership, I expect you to work on your weakness. But as an organization, I want to find the bright sparks and the superhero strength in each of you, because that is what is going to keep the company progressing. We have to focus on your superpower. We have to help you discover your superpower, because some people have superpowers and they do not yet know what it is. And as leaders, that's what we want to do. So we will create more opportunities, but we will help also to prepare you for those opportunities. And I am always heartened by the fact that when I see persons get promoted, this is positive change. This is elevation. And you need to be prepared for that. Because when you get to that new position, we want you to succeed. We don't want you to fail. So then what about you? Then suddenly you have to realize that it's not just about what we do as a leadership. And I don't want to confuse you, but you also realize that we are you, because we are part of the team. So, but I must separate the two for now to start asking you, and that you is broad, that you encompasses everybody in the room, how do you prepare yourself to elevate? Think about it. Perception, positivity, starts with the heart, starts with how you see things, how you interpret things. There was one young lady who told me some months ago, she said, this organization is toxic. And I say, you staying among the poison? Because clearly it was not toxic. She meant something else. Something else was bothering us. So we need to understand how to use the language that allows us to identify the problem so that we could fix it. Yeah? Using the wrong language can be so detrimental. Find the right language. Find the positive language that allows you to improve the environment around you. So, and then there is the whole paradigm of the team. You can have a wonderful organization and you can have wonderful individuals, but if you fail to gel as a team, you just picture the football teams that have all the fancy footballers, they're great footballers, but they are yet to gel and yet to work together to create and to produce good results. So there is that other aspect. Let's elevate the various teams that we have in the organization, and the only people that can do that is you. And don't forget, I am part of you, and we are part of you. It's not confusing, is it? It's very clear to me. Now, it takes me to the awardees in the room. take this particular process, take this particular recognition very, very seriously. Because this is a process of elevation. This is a process of recognition and elevation. And it is said in cliche terms many times, but people will look to you. If she is the standard of what a supervisor of the year is, then I need to be like him or her, right? And so your standard, I dare say, must be impeccable. That is what we're looking for. That is what I expect from you. And that is what I expect to have happened. That's why you are being recognized. So today, I elevate you. Today, I am really, I know it's said as cliche many times, but I am really proud of you. I am really proud of how the room is set up. I'm happy with the venue. A round of applause for Sandals. It's a beautiful place. And I want you to take that time to be present and to understand exactly what this recognition means to you and to us as an organization. Guys, enjoy yourself tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Martin. So he has left us with some words. We will be holding on to our gains and elevate. So ladies and gentlemen, it's my distinct honor and privilege to introduce our esteemed guest speaker for the awards, Dr. Cletus Kennedy Burton. So Dr. Burton is the Executive Director of the Caribbean Electric Utility Services Corporation, CARELEC, and serves as Secretary and Treasurer of the Board and the Corporation. He has led several transformational and organizational development initiatives. Dr. Burton has delivered presentations at numerous regional and international conferences. He has authored several articles, papers, and book chapters, and has served as lecturer. Take note. Monroe College MBA program, University of the West Indies, UWE, Alpha Lockjack Global School of Business, City University Business, and the University of Westminster in London. He has also conducted capacity building sessions for leaders in the public and private sectors in St. Lucia and the region. He holds a Bachelor of Science and Master of Science in Management, specializing in information systems from UWE, and a PhD in Information Systems and Change Management from City University in England. He also successfully completed the Coach Training Intensive Program with the Coaching and Positive Psychology Institute and earned a certificate in Personal Development Coaching from the International Coach Federation. So Dr. Burton has become a familiar figure with us at Massey Stores. He serves as our head professor for the Massey Stores Leadership Program, guiding both current and aspiring Massey leaders, along with conducting leadership development sessions for all our managers. Without further delay, let us extend our warm Massey welcome to Dr. Burton.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, awardees. I'm trying to get the mic out so I could get out of your way. And is there a cordless, perchance, that could be used? Oh, excellent, brilliant. Thank you. Right, thank you for your kind introduction. Just one slight correction, please. The head professorship is not yet, how would I say, awarded, and I can't claim it on my own. So I appreciate the good, foresight. Must be something you speak it into being. So let's see what happens in the near future. But thank you for having me as your guest speaker for tonight. It's truly a wonderful occasion. As I look across the room, you look truly, truly, truly wonderful. A round of applause for yourselves, please. It is truly an awesome sight, and this magnificent room, I think it just befits the occasion. Martin, you really paved the way for what I will, all of what you said is just encapsulating the what I will be saying. So thank you so much for that perfect segue. So tonight I just want to spend a little time talking about seven powerful steps to elevate. And I want to focus this on us, on you, and I'm hoping that you could see some usefulness in some of the steps that we will go through during the presentation. So the seven steps I want to share with you tonight starts with purpose, priorities, passion, preparation, people, perseverance, and patience. So these are the seven steps that I'll run through that I will suggest to us that are very useful or could be very useful as you seek to elevate your careers, your personal growth within the corporation and in a wider sense societally. I hope I'm not in the way of the screen, that's why I'll try to move around from time to time so that I could allow others to see the screen. I know there are other screens around the room. Oh, brilliant, yes. Thank you. So the seventh step starts with purpose, and we'll spend a little more time on purpose than the other steps because I think it is actually the main foundational step, a powerful step to the pathway of elevation. And Martin mentioned it. He said some of us are superheroes, but we're not sure where to hone that superhero ability. I'm not sure if these were exact words, but something to that effect. So it lies in the P of purpose. And first of all, when you talk about elevating to raise, to move to a higher place or position, to lift up, basically, to raise to a higher state, rank, or office, to raise to a higher intellectual or spiritual level. All of these are definitions of the word elevate. And as we think about the concept of elevation and rising up, and as we say, some might say it in a colloquial way of bigging up yourself and rising through, reminds me of a little scenario of three West Indians who were linemen in Miami. I'm not sure if you know about West Indians, when we are outside the region, we are even more patriotic and nationalistic than even when we're in our own countries. You know that? It's when we travel, we appreciate, you know, what we missing at the time, right? So these three West Indians were linemen in Miami, a Jamaican, Trinidadian, and a Barbadian. And so they were just shooting the breeze and looking up into the sky and, you know, trying to, you know, feel good about missing home. And so the talk came to something along the lines of which island was, you know, the best kind of thing. And which island, you know, could do great things. And so for some reason, the Trinidadian started off with looking up at the sky and he saw the moon. He said, you know something? My country and the brilliant scientists in this country that I call Trinidad and Tobago, under my prime minister, will take a man to the moon. First Caribbean country to take a man to the moon. That's what the Trini said. Jamaican obviously was looking for a way to top that. He said, well, my country, with all these brilliant scientists under our prime minister, will take a man to Mars. First human being ever to go to Mars. You know, people have been to the moon, but not from the region. So he topped one time. He said, we'll take a man. So the Bajan now, you know, Bajans now even more patriotic and nationalistic. So the Bajan had to find a way to top that. He said, well, my country, under my prime minister, will take a man to the sun. And one time the Jamaican jumped up and said, man, how are you supposed to do it? The sun go burn him up before he reach. The Bajan said, man, what do you think? You think we're stupid, man? We go in there by night. We'll come back to that at the end. It actually has a purpose, that little story. But purpose, we need to find out what is our life's purpose as the first step to elevate. No one can define that for you. You have to determine what is my life's purpose, not just in the context of Massey, but what gives your life meaning. And it might be related, hopefully, to your career path, but to many other things that complement your career path as well, your skill sets, your natural born talent, etc. But you need to start off, when you're elevating, you need to establish what gives your life meaning. What is your purpose? And companies do it all the time. Organizations that they establish from day one, even before they establish, determine their purpose through various means, and they formalize it through the things you see up on the screen. Memorandum of understanding, the bylaws, partnership agreement, charter, committees even would determine their purpose. Why am I here as an organization, as a legal entity? And they do things along the way to reestablish that purpose. They never take it for granted. They never lose sight of that purpose. Organizations, they do visioning exercises, strategic planning, and SWOT, and PESTEL, and they look at their values, their vision, and they look at goals, all to determine, to establish, and reinforce their purpose to make sure that as an organization, they're on track. As they undertake initiatives, as they set budgets and targets, it's all aligned with their... I'll ask you to help me from time to time, please. It's all aligned to their purpose. To their purpose. Somebody say purpose.
Purpose.
Purpose. I need to hear you make sure that you are wide awake. Purpose is the first thing that organizations do. And a little note here, in thinking about your purpose, I would encourage us to look at the concepts of achievement. I almost said versus, but it's not quite versus. Achievement and fulfillment, success and significance. And these concepts are often used interchangeably, but they're not quite the same. So as you think about your purpose and you seek to achieve things along the lines of your career, achievement means to succeed in finishing something or reaching an aim, especially after a lot of work or effort. Straight dictionary definition, to achieve. To carry out successfully, you say you accomplish something. To attain or get as a result of effort, you've reached somewhere. All of these are meanings of achievement. And that's a good thing. That's a good thing. However, it's different from fulfillment. To be fulfilled means you feel happy because you're getting, well, everything, maybe nearly everything, the important things that you want from life, fulfilled. You feel happiness and contentment. You feel that your abilities and talents are being fully used, providing you with happiness and satisfaction. That's fulfillment. Anybody seen a difference between achievement and fulfillment? Is there a difference? There is a difference between achievement and fulfillment. Achievement, get this, achievement without fulfillment, high achievement without fulfillment is a broken way of life. High achievement, as good as it is, without fulfillment, in keeping with your purpose, is a broken way of life. Excitement comes from the achievement. Nothing wrong with that. Fulfillment comes from the journey that got you there. So in other words, it's possible to feel fulfilled even before you have achieved. So fulfillment is something that you could get all along the way. Oprah Winfrey once says, don't worry about being successful, but work toward being, I think I jumped too far ahead. So achievement and fulfillment are concepts that you need to focus on as you define your purpose. Then there's success, the achievement of results wanted or hoped for. Oprah says, don't worry about being successful, but work towards being, what's that word? And the success will follow. Mandela once said, what counts in life is not the mere fact that we have lived, it is what difference we have made to the lives of that will determine the of the lives that we lead. Again, Oprah says, the key to realizing a dream is to focus not on success, but, and then, get this, and then even the small steps and little victories along your path will take on greater meaning. There's a difference between success and significance. We believe that it's our accomplishments that prove our worth and make for a happy life, but we forget that achievement and fulfillment are not the same thing. So there is purpose. We're still on the first P, and after that we'll roll through the other P's very quickly. What do you want to accomplish? When you add that with meaning, why do you want to accomplish it, then you get fulfillment in terms of how it will make you feel when you accomplish it. So ideally, what we want to do is to align our achievements with our purpose so that we could have a sense of fulfillment. Somebody say fulfillment. Fulfillment. And fulfillment with achievement is a wonderful thing. Because you don't want to have fulfillment necessarily and you're not achieving anything of note. But aligning your achievements with your sense of purpose will bring fulfillment. So live your life on purpose. On purpose. After that, everything flows nicely. Priorities. Purpose then, things which matter most must never be at the mercy of things which matter least. So purpose, priorities and purpose will help keep us on track. Live with purpose and you'll know where you want to go. Live by priority and you'll know what to do to get there. So purpose will define what you prioritize. Yes? Purpose will define what you prioritize. Passion. Purpose is the reason you journey. Passion is the, what's that word? Fire that lights the way. So from purpose, priorities, and then passion will move, will drive you, lighten the way. So purpose, priorities, and passion, we can balance life better when we put passion into perspective and make purpose top priority. So if all the priorities we set, purpose will define our priorities and our passion, our drive, what we put our energies and time towards. Yes? So purpose guides and passion drives. And as a company, managers of this esteemed organization, if you're able to align people's passions with priorities of the organization and themselves based on their purpose, you will achieve performance. Because passion will drive. You won't have to be like a whip. Passion will drive. If you align people's passion with priorities, you will achieve performance. Not just at the individual level, but at the company level, at the departmental level. You will achieve performance. Fourth step is preparation. And again, Martin alluded to it. Preparation is key. Part of success is preparing on purpose. Preparation is not accidental. It's not by the way. It's not they send me and do a workshop, so I come there and my mouth long and they're just waiting for the break and the lunch for me to go about my business. Ton. I've been to 101 of these things, the same thing they tell me all the time. Part of success is preparation on purpose, intentionally, deliberately. And that preparation is not just what we're doing in the workshops. It's holistic. You have to look at the environmental, financial, occupation, all around preparation, holistic preparation. How you take care of yourself emotionally, spiritually, all around. The preparation for fulfillment, for achievement is not just incidental. It has to be on purpose. People. Step number five, people. Surround yourself with people who have the same mission as you. It will help you sail through all of the challenges. Surround yourself with people who have the same goals and mission as you. There's a saying, as iron sharpens iron, so one person sharpens another. So surround yourself with people who will bring out the best in you, who will challenge you, who will call you out when you're slipping up. Not just yes, people will just say, yes, yes, you're right. Who will say, no, I think you're wrong here. I think you could do it this way instead. Iron sharpens iron. There's friction, there's tension, there's... It's not often a nice sound when you hear the sharpening, but it is useful at the end. That's what you want from people closest to you. And make sure, as a caution, make sure everybody in your boat is rowing and not drilling holes when you not know your circle. There will be people in your boat very close to you who will be drilling holes. Not that they're not rowing, you know. After they're not rowing with you, they're drilling holes. And guess what? They're in the boat too, you know. You didn't get that. They're in the boat too. But they don't mind going down once you go down too. Hello, somebody. They don't mind going down once you go down too. They're smiling. I'm like, whoa. It's so. Step number six. Perseverance is stubbornness with a purpose. Perseverance is stubbornness with a purpose. To persevere is to persist in anything undertaken, maintain a, in spite of difficulty, obstacles, or discouragement, continue steadfastly. That's the meaning of persevere. Strength does not come from winning. Your struggles develop your strengths. When you go through hardships and, what's that word? And decide. That is strength. Decide. Meaning you might feel like surrendering. Hello, somebody. You might feel like surrendering. But you have to decide not to surrender. That's perseverance. Because it's not going to be easy. You're going to have bad days. You're going to have challenges. You're going to have the backstabbing. You're going to have the malinging. You're going to have the... But you have to decide. Decide not to surrender. Final P. Patience and perseverance have a magical effect before which difficulties disappear and obstacles vanish. Patience and perseverance. The two go hand in hand. Patience, by the way, is not passive waiting. Sometimes when we're patient, like just wait your turn, just sit there and do nothing, wait. That's not patience. Patience is active. Patience is active acceptance of the process required to attain your goals and dreams. Very important. So patience is not just sitting around waiting and my chance will come and, you know, no. It's active acceptance of the process, meaning that you're doing something, you're preparing, but you are patient. Hello. You're linking up with the right people, but you're patient. You're embracing the process. You understand that it doesn't come overnight. It doesn't come by just nene and power and connections. You understand there's a process, so you're patiently working your way through the process. Patiently working your way through the process. Patience doesn't mean just sitting down doing nothing. So here are the seven steps in conclusion as we wrap up. Purpose, priorities, passion, preparation, people, perseverance, and patience will help us to elevate within the context of Massey and life in general. Never compare your journey to life with anyone else's. Never compare. Your journey is your journey, not a competition. Many of us get frustrated and discouraged because we're looking and looking and looking and comparing. Your time is your time. Hello. Your time to shine will be your time to shine. Get your fulfillment along the way as you head towards achievement and move towards elevation. It's your journey. Each and every one of our journey is distinct and unique and special. Find joy in the journey. Joy in the journey. Be fulfilled along the way. And going back to our three West Indian friends in Miami as we close. You ever heard the saying, every dark cloud has a silver lining? Ever heard that saying? Every dark cloud has a silver lining. You know why? Dark clouds come in our lives and we may not see the silver lining. Sometimes the dark clouds are so extensive from what we see, we don't see the silver lining. We don't see the brightness anywhere in the sky. And we may not feel the warmth and comfort that we need to move on that path of elevation. But when does the sun stop shining? The Bajan said we go in there by night. When does the sun stop shining? Is there anybody? In the night? In the night? The sun doesn't stop shining. It is the earth that rotates on its axis, and at times we get darkness and at times we get light. And so in our lives, there will be darkness, there will be dark clouds. Even in the day, there will be darkness. And it's possible sometimes in the day when you see the silver lining on the clouds, what is causing the silver lining on the dark cloud is the sun that is still shining. And even in the night when we see darkness, the sun is still shining. That's why the book says, weeping may endure for a night, but comes in the morning. As sure as night turns into day, it will come. So when dark clouds come in our lives and we feel that we can't elevate to the extent that we want, remember, the sun is always shining. And it is sometimes we who turn away from the sun that causes the darkness that we face. Hello, somebody. And so along the lines of the amen, if you change the sun, S-U-N, to S-O-N, capital S, hello somebody. Hey, somebody. The sun is always shining. And so whether it's day or night, the sun is there. We just have to wait until we see the sunlight again. We don't have to wait for long because it's shining all the time. So every dark cloud has a silver lining because the sun, S-U-N or S-O-N, capital S, is always shining. Somebody say amen. You started it. So be comforted, dear soul. There is always light behind the clouds. Always light behind the clouds. And so if I were to say, let's slip in one more P, we pray. Thank you and congratulations.
Testing. Okay. Oh, Dr. Burton, what an inspiring presentation. The seven P's to elevate. Don't you agree, guys? Hello, somebody. Amen. So it's time for the presentation of the awards. Now, the Spirit Award, Nicola kind of gave us a little interlude beforehand, so people have started voting. However, we wanted to read the six bios of the persons or the nominees for the Spirit Award. So if you could bear with me. And once that is done, I guess we'll leave about 2 minutes and then close the poll. And then we will present the winner a little later down. So our Spirit nominees, Evian Davidson, Supervisor Marcy Mega. Evian, oh. Oh, Evian, I always Evie her, so. So Evian has consistently showcased her dedication to excellence and nurturing a positive workplace. As a mentor for newcomers, her unparalleled commitment to their development has been key in their successful integration and growth within our team. As a certified Massey Stores trainer, Evian has enriched her peers with essential skills through comprehensive training programs. Her mentoring and training roles have significantly contributed to our team's professional development and overall success. Engaging in the latest leadership program among middle management, Evian has proven her dedication to continuous personal and professional enhancement. Her involvement in the hiring process has also been crucial, providing insights that ensure we onboard talent and perfectly aligns with our organizational values. Moreover, Evian's leadership in managing allocation has showcased her strong organizational abilities, playing a pivotal role in the operational success of her assigned areas. Recently, Evian's efforts in coordinating HR activities, notably our Family Day event, highlighted her creativity and commitment. The event's success under her guidance fostered greater team collaboration and camaraderie. Evian. Next, we have Janica Lamontagne, Supervisor Souffre Lapeur. Janica's warm demeanor and resourcefulness have positioned her as a valuable asset to our team. Continuously evolving, Janica's dedication promises limitless potential for future achievements. In her brief tenure, Janica has exceeded her role's expectations by actively supporting the HR training department in delivering sessions across the Castries and Souffre Basin. This underscores her commitment to excellence and her readiness to contribute beyond her designated scope. Notably, Janica's ability to enhance her skill set and provide added value illustrates her unwavering dedication to personal and professional growth. Moreover, during HR-led initiatives, Janica has showcased her proficiency in effectively leading and engaging her team. Her proactive approach to maintaining team morale and engagement significantly contributes to the overall success of her location. Next, we have Mindy Mitchell, Store Supervisor, Chauzel. Mindy operates with a can-do attitude, never hesitating to tackle any task. She handles challenges without complaint and often brings humor and often brings humor to her interactions. Her customer service skills are exceptional, marked by a genuine passion for her work. Demonstrating unwavering dedication and loyalty, she consistently goes above and beyond to ensure the smooth operations of the store. Always eager to assist and share her expertise, she embodies a proactive approach to learning and growth. She is a go-getter, seizing every opportunity to expand her knowledge and skills. With her reliable and dependable nature, she can be counted on at any time. Additionally, her ability to inspire and mobilize the team showcases her leadership qualities. Mindy is not only a team player, but a catalyst for collective participation in store and broader company projects, demonstrating exceptional flexibility and initiative in leading these efforts to fruition. Mindy. Oleander Kazimi, Customer Service Representative at Massey Stores City Store. So Oleander excels in providing support to both internal and external customers, serving as an invaluable service ambassador. She consistently upholds the highest level of professionalism, particularly in addressing health and safety issues, and actively participates in company extracurricular activities on a voluntary basis. Known for her warmth and welcoming demeanor, Oleander always delivers service with a smile. Oleander continues to shine brightly like a diamond, radiating her positivity across the various departments she interacts with daily. She remains attentive and proactive, going above and beyond to keep internal and external customers informed about promotions and product availability on the shelves. Her enthusiasm for executing promotions in stores is infectious, and feedback from the marketing team commends her unwavering commitment to assist with execution and provide feedback. Oleander's ability to bring joy and comfort even during challenging times is truly commendable. We are incredibly fortunate to have such a dedicated team member who has grown significantly in her role while continuing to spread sunshine wherever she goes. Oleander. So next we have Shoma Victor, Front End Department Head, Supervisor at Sunny Acres. Shoma radiates enthusiasm, fueled by her profound passion for business, and consistently goes the extra mile without hesitation when the situation demands. She embodies the core values of our organization, displaying a genuine interest in the growth of her colleagues and empowering them to succeed. Actively engaging in all company-sponsored extracurricular events, Shoma wholeheartedly dedicates herself to ensuring her team's triumph. She exemplifies unwavering support for team leaders in attaining objectives. In her most recent endeavors, Shoma took the lead as a committee member for the Family Fun sports event, rallying her team for support and participation. Additionally, she enthusiastically participated in the inter-commercial fun sports led and hosted by Vibe Radio. Currently holding the position of head supervisor at Sunny Acres, Shoma's journey to this role has been marked by excellence from her supervisory role at Rodney B. She demonstrated her flexibility when she promptly took on crucial responsibility, ensuring the smooth operation and proper closure of the LeClerie location during the night shift in the absence of the store manager. With a proven record of success and a willingness to take on new challenges, Shoma continues to inspire those around her as she continues to grow within the organization. And our final nominee, Taj Andrew, Meat Cutter Warehouse. Taj Andrew exemplifies our core values of collaboration, consistently fostering teamwork among his colleagues. His ability to complete tasks promptly and offer support voluntarily at the city store location underscores his dedication to the company's success. Taj approaches every assignment with a proactive attitude, readily assisting without complaint and actively participating in company events. He embodies a diligent worker with a humble yet assertive demeanor, showcasing competencies that align with our organizational values. Affectionately known as the Yes Guy, Taj consistently delivered invaluable service to his division and beyond. Taj's willingness to lend a hand knows no bounds. He readily takes on additional tasks with enthusiasm, demonstrating his positive attitude and commitment to excellence. Taj's encouragement and appreciation for teamwork is evident in his interactions with colleagues. He is quick to acknowledge others' efforts and offer words of encouragement, fostering a culture of positivity and camaraderie. Taj embodies the true spirit of Massey. So we're gonna cue some music, I guess, and then we will close the poll. So, pardon? Yes, persons online, on YouTube, you are seeing the code so that you can vote as well. Okay? DJ, where my music? Okay, let me sing. Ta na na, ta na 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 na. I cannot. Sing with me, people. Okay, so now we continue on to the next award. We go in with the Team Member of the Year Award. I just want to remind everyone, as you come up for your award, please use stage right. When you get your award, you stop, take a picture, and then, oh sorry, you stage left. That's stage right. Pass there, people. Come up for your award, pause, take your picture, pass behind me, and go down the steps, and remember to hold the railings, okay? So Team Member of the Year. So my co-host. So Team Member of the Year. The Team Member of the Year Award stands as a testament to the exceptional contributions and unwavering dedication of individuals within our team. This prestigious recognition celebrates not only outstanding performance, but also the embodiment of our core values and the fostering of positive relationships within the workplace. As we bestow this honor upon deserving recipients, we acknowledge their significant impact on our team and organization as a whole. To be eligible for the distinguished title of Team Member of the Year, candidates must meet rigorous criteria, consistently delivering top-tier productivity and maintaining stellar work quality, demonstrating exceptional dependability and proactive initiative, embodying our core values of honesty, integrity, care, growth, responsibility, collaboration, and respect, with a consistently positive attitude and fostering positive, constructive relationships with colleagues through exemplary interpersonal skills. I would like to call on Lucretia Duncan and Heidi Klesser to give the awards. Lucretia. I would like also call Delis Christopher to assist.
Okay, so we're gonna get started with Marcy Stores Rodney Heights. The nominees are Dacia Joseph, Charlene Eliador, Jessica Clark, and Marcella Maida. Our winner for this award is none other than Charlene Eliador. Come on out, Charlene. Thank you. Love the energy. Love it. All right. Next up, Marcy Storrs Rodneby. The nominees are Owen Brown, Sophia St. Rose, Trendy McDoom, and Theophilus Bruce. The winner is Owen Brown. Come on up, Owen. Give it up for Owen. Moving on to Marcy Storrs Mega. The nominees are Claudia Haynes, Reality Shalmine, Bernice Trim, Shanta Williams,
oh gosh,
Shalima Joseph. And the winner is Bernice Trim. Come on up, Bernice. It's a walk of fame. You all good. Hold the railings. So Eve is collecting on her behalf. Bernice is not here with us today. Tonight. Moving on to Marcy Storrs Gourmet. Nominees are Alana Budu, Nandrani Sham, and Natalie Altius. The winner is Nandrani Sham. Give it up for Nandrani. All right, moving on to Marcy Storrs Sunny Acres. The nominees are Leah Charles, Leonora Charles, yeah. Zara Hunter, Donna Monroe, and the winner is Leonora Charles. Coming up, Leonora. Hey, 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 hey. Give it up for Leonora Charles. Okay, moving on to Marcy Stars Lacleri. The nominees are Shane Baptiste, Muriel Octave, Lois Joseph, all right, Candia Ogis, Pearl Bousset. Okay. The winner is Pearl Bousset. Us tonight, so Leslie Ann will be picking up on her behalf. Still give it up for Pearl. Moving on to Marcy Stars Waterfront. The nominees are Kesha Augustine, Chanel Terrence, and Cindy Wilson. The winner is Cindy Wilson. Up to me. Give it up for Cindy. Alright, moving on to Marcy City Store. The nominees are Stacy Celestine, Dwayne Daniel, Gary Antoine, and Neria John. The winner is Stacy Celestine. Give it up for Stacy! Okay, moving on to Marcy Stars Home. The nominees are Adrian Reynolds, Hermaine Braville. Shirley Sonny. And Nissa Cassius.
Oh, of course, Nissa.
The winner is Shirley Sonny. Give it up for Shani! Shanai, I'm sorry. Give it up for Shanai one more time. I got you. All right, moving on to Marcy Starr's cul-de-sac. The nominees are Anicia Nurse, Chrissy Eugene, Chrissy Joaquin, Noella Alfred. And the winner is Anicia Nurse. Give it up for Anicia. For Marcy Starr's Dry Warehouse, we're going straight to the winner here. No frills. The winner is Patrice Alba. Go, Patrice! Woo! Oh, gosh. Boy, Patrice, I want to be like you when I grow up, you know? Oh. One more time for Patrice! Hey, hey, hey. Now for Marcy Starr's Perishables Warehouse. The nominees are Junior Eugene and Ali Augustine. The winner is Ali Augustine. Boy, Ali looking sharp. Give it up for Ali. Moving on to Marcy Starr's Mini. The nominees are Delon Fatal, Kesha Gustav, and Crystal Flermius. The winner is Delon Fatal. Yeah. Give it up for Mr. Feta. Moving on to Marcy Stores LaPelle. The nominees are Cleo Luisi, Heather Pascal, Elma Saint-Remy, and Zachary Gillard. The winner is Heather Pascal. Give it up for Heather! Hey, 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 hey. Moving on to Marcy Stores Latuni. Shozel down the road. The nominees are Marky Clovis, Jade Shallery, Brenda Snag, and McQueen Elaine. The winner is Brenda Snag. Give it up for Brenda. Next, we have Marcy Stores New Doc. Don't worry, Chazelle come in. Chazelle come in. The nominees are Tracy Gustav, Sharla Severin, and Richie Simon. The winner is Sharla Severin. Leah will be collecting Charlotte's award on her behalf. Give it up for Charlotte! All right, so now we're circling back to Chazelle. So Marcy Stores Chazelle, the nominees are Brittany Herman, Annette Nicholas, Crystal Lamontage, and Mahala Downs. Mahala, I'm sorry. The winner is Annette Nicholas. Yeah. Give it up for Annette. Moving on to Loss Prevention Department. The nominees are Johnietta Thomas, Sylvia King, Sylvanias Bousset. The winner is Sylvanias Bousset. Moving on to Commercial Central Kitchen. The nominees are Bronilla Peter, Misha Dalfinis. Did I say it right? Mishka. Okay. I'm getting there. Gailene Leo. GLN? Gailene Leo. GLN? There's this one. Hold on, 1 second, please. We have one more nominee. Yes. Eugene Sylvester. And the winner is Eugene Sylvester. Give it up for Miss Sylvester. She says she's trembling, y'all. Give her some warmth. All right, on to our final one for this category, Mercy Distribution. We're going straight ahead with this one as well. The winner is Gloria Phillips. Give it up for Gloria!
Thank you, Lucretia and Delise, looking lovely. That's the operation standard, people. Notice. So we go into our next category of awards, Supervisor of the Year. So the Supervisor of the Year award is a distinguished honor that acknowledges exemplary leadership, dedication, and commitment within our organization. Supervisors play a pivotal role in driving success, fostering team collaboration, and cultivating a positive work environment. As we outline the criteria for this prestigious award, we emphasize the importance of leadership qualities, team engagement, and the ability to inspire and motivate others. To be eligible for the esteemed title of Supervisor of the Year, candidates must exceed expectations in various critical areas, including demonstrating exceptional leadership skills, actively engaging in team development, driving performance excellence, fostering positive relationships both within the team and with external stakeholders, as well as maintaining exemplary attendance and punctuality, setting a standard of reliability and commitment for their team members to emulate. So let's invite Janice Lionel and Hendria to give out the awards. The operation standard.
All right, so we're gonna get started with Marcy Stores Rodney Heights. The nominees are Bradley Augustine, Marcella Maidard, Miranda Job, Job. Okay, Job, Francine John, Samantha Aaron. And the winner is Francine John. Give it up for Francine. Moving on to Marcy Stars, Rodney Bay. The nominees are Tara Hippolyte, Roseanne Clark, and Vandy Lucien. The winner is Tara Hippolyte. Give it up for Tara. Moving on to Marcy Stores Gourmet. The nominees are Elvis Francis, Valicia Leonard Ferdinand, Martin Isaac, and Sandra Joseph. The winner is Valicia Leonard Ferdinand. Hey. Give it up for Valicia! Moving on to Marcy Stores Mega. Nominees are Josette St. Mar, Glenda Joseph, Evian Davidson, and the winner is Josette St. Mar. Give it up for Jose! Moving on to Marcy Stores Sunny Acres. The nominees are Idelma Joseph, Erlan Similian, and Shane Emmanuel. The winner is Erlan Similian. Our still is on Erlan Similian. I'm sorry. Shema will be collecting on Erlan's behalf. Still, give it up for Erlan for winning this award. Marcy Stores, Lacleary. The nominees are Alicia Matherin, Alicia Matherin, Sharon Alberti, and Jacqueline Taylor. The winner is Sharon Alberti! Give it up for Sharon! Marcy Stores Waterfront. The nominees are Effie Marcel. I'm gonna have to change my job to butcher after this, okay? Donna Arthur. Kirania Peter. Kirania? Marceline Polius. The winner is Miss Marcel! Give it up for Effie! Moving on to Marcy Stars, City Star. I got it right.
Yes.
I got it right. Nominees are Jeremiah Eugene, Nadia Edward, Desiree Pierre, and Sharla Cools. The winner is Jeremiah Eugene. Leander will be collecting on Jeremiah's behalf. Still, give it up for Jeremiah! Moving on to Marcy Stars Home. Nominees are Atal Luizi and Skitter Modest. The winner is Atal Luizi. Give it up for Atta! Moving on to Marcy Stars Cul-de-sac. The nominees are Vicky Joseph and Magdalene Polio. The winner is Vicky Joseph. Give it up for Vicky. Moving on to Marcy Stars Dry Warehouse. The nominees are Everton Lambert and Kervin Gabriel. The winner is Everton Lambert. Thank you. Give it up for Everton. Moving on to Marshy Stores Perishables Warehouse. The nominees are Denise Thomas. And Sylvester Epifan. And the winner is There's more? Ooh! Ooh, boosh! Ooh, boosh! We have one more nominee. It's on the other side. Siobhan Augustine. And now, the winner is Sylvester Epifan. Wayne will be collecting on Sylvester's behalf. Please still give it up for Sylvester. Thank you, Wayne. Moving on to Marcy Stores Lapel. The nominees are Leonina. Did I say that right?
Yes.
Daniel. Woo. Cindy Charles. Shakira Joseph. Janica Lamontagne. The winner is. Maybe. Shakira Joseph! Miss Mafra will be collecting on her behalf. Give it up for Shakira. Moving on to Marcy Stores, Latuni. The nominees are Angela Rene. Siobhan Joseph and Glenda Dennis. The winner is Angela Rene. Give it up for Angela. Moving on to Marcy Stores New Dock. The nominees are Miranda Tal Nassis, Della Clovis, and Michael Jeremy. The winner is Della Clovis. Give it up for Della! Hey, 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 hey. Moving on to Marcy Stars Chozelle. Woo, oh boy, Chozelle, big up. Nominees are Jane Leos. Janie Leos. Janie Leos, Emily Bellas, thank you. Mindy Mitchell, Sharon Jetram Francis, and the winner is Mindy Mitchell. Give it up for Mindy! Moving on to Loss Prevention Department. The nominees are Kimasha Remy, McDonald Pamphil, Sheena Francis, and the winner is Kimasha Remy. Give it up for Kimasha. She just said she's telling her mother for me. I'm in trouble. Moving on to Marcy Stars Mini. The nominees are Nadir Alcindor and Melissa Flavier. The winner is Nadir Alcindor. Give it up for Nadir.
Thank you, Janice. Thank you, Hendria. We're moving on to the Standing Ovation Award. The Standing Ovation Award is a distinguished honor bestowed upon individuals who have made extraordinary contributions to our organization, leaving an indelible mark through their dedication, innovation, and outstanding achievements. This award serves as a symbol of our appreciation for their exceptional efforts and a testament to their commitment to excellence. Delise Arnold and Cecilia Mitchell, can you come up and help with the awards?
All right, so we're starting with Massey Distribution. The nominees are Cindy Francis, Kevin Joseph, and McNeil Thomas. The winner is Kevin Joseph. Give it up for Kevin! Next up, we have Category Management, Merchandising, and Sales. The nominees are Trudy Anius, and Benita Jachals. The winner is Trudy Anius. Give it up for Trudy! Moving on to marketing and corporate communication. Not saying, you know, that's the best one, but... Right. I was told to behave. Okay. The nominees are Samantha Morissette and Kittel Raphael Dubois. The winner is Samantha Morissette. Big up you. Give it up for Samantha. Moving on to customer service. The nominees are Kayla Louise and Estelita Samuel. The winner is Estelita Samuel. Give it up for Esther! Yeah. And now for human resources, we're going straight to the winner here. The winner is Hendria Calderon. Give it up for Andrea! And now for purchasing perishables. The winner is Yolanda Ford. Your land. I had an A to your name, eh? Sorry. Give it up for your land. Moving on to purchasing non-foods. The nominees are Janelle Joseph and Joy Narcisse. The winner is Janelle Joseph. Give it up for Janelle. Moving on to purchasing grocery. The nominees are Asha Emmanuel and Dylan Smith. The winner is Asha Emmanuel. Give it up for Asha. Sorry, Skitter. Skitter will be collecting on Asha's behalf. Moving on to compliance and consumer finance. The winner is Sasha Joseph. Give it up for Sasha. Moving on to warehousing and logistics. The nominees are Cassandra Jabatis and Peter Valse. The winner, oh boy, the winner is Cassandra Jabatis. Give it up for Cassandra! And now for white foods and after sales. White goods. Woo! I must be hungry. I must be hungry. White goods and after sales. The nominees are Meladrin Isidore.
Meladrin? Meladrin? Oh, it has an R.
Meladrin Isidore. And Kelvin Joseph. And the winner is Kelvin Joseph! Give it up for Kelvin! And now for business systems and IT. The nominees are Marvin Mathre and Kendall Morell. And the winner is Marvin Mathre! Oh gosh, boy, IT is lively. Love it. Give it up for Marvin! And now for finance. The nominees are Vanasia Shalry and Jovian Dyer. The winner is Vanasha Salary. Give it up for Miss Salary. Last but not least, pharmacy. We're going straight to the winner here. The winner is Genevieve Peterson. Give it up for Genevieve.
Thank you, Delise and Celia. So we're moving on to our Perfect Attendance Award. Perfect attendance is more than just a record of attendance.
It's a testament to dedication, reliability, and commitment. It represents individuals who have consistently shown up, rain or sunshine, to contribute their best selves to our company. As we celebrate and acknowledge those who have achieved perfect attendance, we reflect on the values they embody and the example they set for all of us. To qualify for this prestigious recognition, individuals must fulfill the following criteria: unwavering consistency in both punctuality and attendance throughout the review period, with not a single instance of tardiness noted. Demonstrated exemplary attendance throughout the entire year, with no absences recorded, whether certified or uncertified. So Sabina Wilkie and Sherilyn Victor will help us with those awards.
So grateful for your sunshine. I feel a movement taking over.
Okay, so we're starting with Massey Stores Rodney Bay. The winner is Sophia Sandrose. Give it up for Sophia! Hey, 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 hey. For Marcy Stores Gourmet, the winner is Tamara Gill Alfred!
Hey, hey, hey.
Give it up for Tamara! For Marcy Stores Mega, the winner is Pierre George! Give it up for Pierre! For Marcy Stores Sunny Acres, the winner is Donna Monroe! Round of applause for Donna. For Marcy Stores Waterfront, the winner is Lorna Ferguson. Give it up for Lorna! Chanel is picking up for Lorna. For Marcy Stores City Store, the winner is Neria John! Give it up for Neria. For Marcy Stores Cul-de-sac, the winner is Chrissy Joaquin. Give it up for Chrissy. For Marcy Stores Dry Warehouse, the winner is Donatas Emmanuel. Give it up for Mr. Emmanuel! For Marcy Stores Perishables Warehouse, the winner is Wayne Albert! Give it up for Wayne! And now, for Marcy Stores Mini. The winner is Kijina St. Bryce! Give it up for Kijina! For Marcy Stores Lapel, the winner is Neela Butcher! Round of applause for Neela. For Marcy Stores Latuni, the winner is Jamal Williams. Give it up for Jamal! For Marcy Stores New Dock, the winner is Frances Maxwell! Hey. Round of applause for Frances. For Marcy Stores Chauzel, the winner is Annette Nicholas. Give it up for Annette. And last but not least, Loss Prevention Department. The winner is Patrick Noel. Give it up for Patrick!
Thank you, Sabina. Thank you, Sherilyn. So what we've all been waiting for, the Spirit Award. Dunstan, can I invite you, the spirit of Massey Stores, to present the award? So the polls are closed. I feel a movement taking over. So after two, I want you to shout who your winner is. For the Spirit Award.
Yeah.
After two. Yeah. One, two.
Done.
Okay, so the winner of the Spirit Award for 2024 is, drum roll.
Drum roll.
And move to the screen. And the winner is? Janica LaMontagne. Thank you, Dunstan. So right now we have a special rendition from a team member of ours. DJ?
Almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming. There's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost below the edges. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep
Give it up for our very own Paulina Lubra. I wish I could sing like that, you know. I could try. You want me to try? Wow. I'll remember that. Okay. So we're moving on to the Health and Safety Award. I'd like to call on Gordon Charles and Maya Felix.
For your sunshine, I feel a movement taking over.
Good evening, everyone. The Health and Safety Location of the Year Award. Some of the measurable safety performance indicators for winning this award includes 1, an above average work area audit score. Candidates for this award must have demonstrated a higher percentage score and satisfactory compliance with safe operating procedures in areas including, but not limited to, housekeeping, cleaning and sanitation, repairs and maintenance, fire safety. The winner of this award had the second highest work area audit score of 85.5%. Number 2. Low recordable incident rates. The location must have demonstrated minimal occupational accidents and recordable injuries that resulted in certified medical leave and subsequently days away from work.
The winner of this award was one of six other locations with zero recordable employee injuries. Number three, a high safety perception score. The location must demonstrate a high percentage score in the group's annual safety culture survey. The survey measures the perceptions and opinions of employees and managers in performance areas such as safety leadership and commitment, safety communication and knowledge, safety involvement and recognition. The winner of this award had the highest participation rate in the annual safety survey, and their safety perception score was 82%, which was 13 points higher than the company's average. So essentially, that location had a good perception of safety. In addition to all of these numbers, all of these quantitative data, the award also relies on observing and recording the actual behaviors and actions of employees and managers in the workplace. Health and safety assistant Hendria said that this particular relation just has a vibe, she calls it, right? Everyone always seems to be on point when she visits, and they tend to want to engage with her on safety issues. They understand the consequences of taking risk at work. During a recent visit, one of the team members expressed to a leadership team member that supervisors and managers at that location are very strict on not taking shortcuts or not following safety procedures. They said, if they see any team member not following procedures or taking shortcuts, they will immediately stop them. When it comes to working safely and being productive, their view is that both are important and must be practiced. It is my privilege to announce that the Health and Safety Location of the Year Award goes to Massey Stores Choiseul. So the Choiseul team, come up, collect your award. Thank you for all you've been doing with regards to health and safety. Let's give them a round of applause.
Thank you, Gordon and Maya. Thank you, Choiseul. And now for the Customer Service Award, I'd like to call on Shania Harrow.
So grateful for your sunshine. I feel a movement taking over. Lean on me, you'll be alright.
Ladies and gents, esteemed colleagues, please bear with me. I sacrificed my glasses for some lashes tonight. You gotta look fab. It is my honor and privilege to be here with you today to recognize and celebrate the outstanding achievements of our exceptional team. This team has consistently gone above and beyond in delivering exceptional service to our valued customers. The unwavering dedication and professionalism, commitment to service excellence have set a high standard for customer service within our organization. Please join me in congratulating and applauding our team for their outstanding performance and unwavering commitment to delivering exceptional customer service. Our customer service award goes to Danny.
Our customer service award goes to, can anyone guess? Marcy Star Joseph.
For your dedication, for setting a shining example for all of us to follow. Congratulations.
Hey, 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 hey. Give it up for Joselle!
Salinas Hippolyte to present this award. This award recognizes not only the dedication and hard work of the entire team, but also the unwavering commitment to providing exceptional service to each and every customer. This store has consistently gone above and beyond to ensure that every customer interaction is a positive and memorable experience. It is clear it's not just business as usual for this location, but the appeal of the community that values and prioritizes the relationships they have with their customers. The dedication to service excellence sets them apart and serves as a shining example for others to follow. Please join me in congratulating the Service Excellence Award to Massey Stores.
New Dawn! Next up, I would like to call on Mr. Martin Dorville and Nicola Velena Paul. They will be giving the awards for Best Performing Store Award, Best Performing Warehouse Award, and Best Performing Home Store. Give it up for Martin and Nicola!
When I see me, this is magic guarantee.
Good evening again, everybody. So this year, as I indicated, we tried to expand the range of awards we would give. So normally, at this point, we would have done one award for the location of the year, but recognizing and wanting again to elevate and encourage, we decided to separate some key areas. So first of all, you had the HSSE, which we just did. We also separated from the location of the year, we separated the warehouses and the home stores. So this year, instead of one award, we have three separate awards for each business type within the Massey stores. We also decided to give separate awards for our employee engagement scores. So the employee engagement, we separated it between the service divisions. So there's a prize for the service division who would have received the highest employee engagement score, and the location that would have received the highest employee engagement score. So, without further ado, I would like to announce for the employee engagement score for the service divisions, the award goes to category management, merchandising, and sales. Come on, guys, give them a round of applause. And incidentally, they had the highest engagement score throughout the entire organization. Mrs. Oje isn't there, but I'm sure she'd be very proud and she's listening. For the location engagement, the location with the highest engagement score, Soufre Lapel. Congratulations. So we now move on to the best performing awards for the various locations. The best performing home store, Massey Home, Latuni. We now move on to our guys, the part of the organization where we have the most male staff, our warehouses. The best performing warehouse award goes to Cul-de-sac Warehouse. In terms of the criteria for the awards, it would be the various locations, the engagement scores, the HSSE scores, and the financials. So it is not just about financial achievements and financial numbers, but it's also about health and safety, and I think Maya went through the entire criteria. So every location actually had a health and safety score. every location had an HSSC score, and thanks to Solange and Sabina, every location had a financial score, and those are what were tabulated and put together to get the locations for the warehouse, the home store, and this final award that I'm giving, I will announce, which is for the best performing store. What I will do is I will announce the top five stores. last year, who won last year? Trozell won last year. Okay, so do you think Trozell won this year again?
Yes.
Okay. Here we go. So we had a couple ties. No hats or anything, just ties. In position number fifth, we had a tie between Massey City Store and Massey Mini. For third place, we also had a tie, Massey New Dock and Massey Rodney Bay. Number two, Massey Trozell. So this means this year we have a new winner. We have a new winner. Who do you think it is? Is it in Castries, in the north? Is it in the south? Is it on the west coast? The winner for the best performing store, having received the highest engagement score, Massey Stores Lapel. Have somewhere another one from the West Coast. So the challenge is good, being thrown out to all the locations. You see that, and what I will tell you is that for both, what I saw for both last year and this year is that the store that had the top financial performance did not win the overall score. So it is, and as you can see here also, we had many awards. We have customer service, HSC engagement. So it is not just about your finance, but it's also about how you, your people, engagement, HSSE, customer service. So it is an performance overall, well-rounded stores. Congratulations to everybody.
Hi, I'm here to share the gratitude and the closing remarks. To all the individuals who worked tirelessly behind the scenes to plan, organize, and execute this event, thank you for your dedication, creativity, and hard work. Your commitment to excellence has made this award ceremony truly remarkable. We are deeply grateful to you for your contributions and honored to have the opportunity to celebrate together. Your support and collaboration have made this evening unforgettable. Thank you once again for your invaluable contributions. We look forward to many more successful collaborations in the future. Now, I understand that all of you are a bit hungry, as am I.